I'm thinking that Alfie's got to come down and be with us. Pete, you've got to come back and be with us. It's been a while. Thank the Lord for each and every one that come. Thank the Lord for all the Gokums. Really, it just ain't the same when they ain't here. You know, I praise the Lord for them. I praise the Lord for everybody, Sisterella, that's in the body of Christ. Because in some way or another, we're all connected. He has joined us. He is fitly joining us together, and I praise Him for it. You know, He is an awesome Savior. He's wonderful. He's mighty, and He's everything that we need. And you know, He's been showing me some things and dealing with me on some stuff. And I think a lot of it is how we look at it sometimes, and or it has been for me. It's the way you look at things, and how that I was thinking. You know, we're getting in God's Word, and it is His Word. It's the written Word, but it takes that revelated Word to add life to your bones. It gives you life. The revelated Word, the letter is dead, but the Spirit, it gives life. And I praise Him that, you know, that He is doing that. And this day He has given us more and more revelated Word. And I know that it's because it's so bad needed. You know, sometimes I feel like we're behind of what we should be. But, you know, He's a right on time God. You know, He's always been right on time. But I think sometimes we're the ones that's been lacking. And He's opened up that book, and He's revelating it more and more to us each day that we live, because we're getting ready to face some time, Sister Joanne, and they're going to come on us real quickly. You know, He said He would come as a thief in the night when we least expected Him, but He still told us what there was some things to look for. He said, you know, that He wouldn't keep anything from us, but He would let us know all things, and He has given us things to look for to see what time is coming up on us. And people don't have much time to get themselves ready. You know, I'm thinking, you know, just as it was when the prophet went to Hezekiah, and he told him, he said, you know, you need to set your house in order because you're surely going to die. I think that we're very close to that time. I think the Lord is speaking out, crying out to His people to get their house in order, because He is really coming back. He is surely coming back, and it'll be at a time that we least expect Him. So we've got to be watchful all the time. You know, a good watchman never quits watching. And I praise Him that He has let us know that. But He was showing me some things about how people would say that they love Him. You know, the first of all commandments is, "Hear ye, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and we must love Him with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength." And I got to thinking about that. That's putting Him first. We always talking about putting Him first, and how that He has to be first. He won't fall even to second place. He has to be number one in our lives. And you know, I love Him with everything that I got, and I'm always saying that. He is my everything. I know that He is my way through. You know, I love that word. I can't get enough of that word, Sister Joanne. But he was dealing with me on love. And are we really loving Him the way that we should be loving Him? You know, when that word is coming through, that revelated word, are we just getting it and letting it settle on us and trying to follow after that by ourselves? Or are we letting it get down in our spirit, rooted and grounded in? Because it has to be rooted and grounded in. You know, He's not just a man that's called Jesus to me. He's not just a spirit that's called by the Holy Ghost that lives in me. His name is Jesus. He is a part of me. And He was showing me that, how that sometimes we'll hear something and we'll get set in the way of just trying to follow it out in the flesh, because a lot of people are doing that. We're following after things, walking in the flesh. You know, you've been taught since you was been old enough to remember anything, "Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal." Well, is that just a way of life that you've gotten into, or is it grounded and rooted in there so deep, Sister Felicia, that you just can't do it whatsoever? It ain't something that you think about not doing. You just don't do it because it's not a part of you anymore, because it's not a part of that man named Jesus. He didn't make it a part. Are we saying that we love our brothers and we're really not loving them? Because if the brother is in the body with you, then we should be loving him automatically. It's not something that we should have to think about, but it should be born in us. Because when Jesus is born in us, then that's the way it's going to be. You know, it's going to be a part of you. It's not just something that you're trying to walk by anymore, but it is something that's in you, and it's your life, and you live it. You don't even have to think about it. It's just there. You know, I was praising him that he was showing me that about how we was loving him. You know, when you love somebody, they're your everything. When you love somebody, they're your heartbeat. When you love somebody, you feel like they're your breath. And when that somebody is gone, you feel like a part of you died. And it's very hard on you. Jesus is never going to die. He's never going to leave. But we're going to have to love him like that. Amen. He is my breath of the morning. He is my breath all day long. He is my heartbeat. He is my every heartbeat. I love him with everything that I got. I don't want to wake up tomorrow if he's not going to be with me. I wouldn't want to wake up, open my eyes, or nothing else. Sister Ralphie, there's a lot out there that don't have him. They are opening up their eyes without him every morning. But I'm here to tell you the reason that I'm standing here is because of Jesus. Yeah, he is my reason for standing. And we're going to have to get deeper in the Word, church. And we're going to have to make it become a part of us instead of something we're just hearing. And then we're learning to live by. It's going to have to become a part of us. It's going to have to be rooted and grounded in. We're going to have to get it in there. And we won't have to think about things anymore. But it's automatically going to be something that we do. I don't have to ask the world or ask myself of the mornings, do I love Felicia? I don't know that I love her. She may hurt me before she leaves the building tonight, but you know what? I love her anyway. There's no other thing that I can do because that is Jesus in me. It's nothing of myself, but it's all of him. If we're birthing forth him, then his word is what we got to birth forth. It's got to become our life. And you know, I've just been thinking on that and how that he was showing me all of this stuff, Brother Mark, because the other morning I was sitting at the house and I was thinking, I think it was Monday morning after service Sunday night, and you know I meditate on that word for a long time. Each time we have a service, I'm meditating on the word for a while. I want it to feed me. I don't want a message that's going to go away before I get home, but I want to soak it all in, Sister Edith. I want to get every bit of it in, and when I didn't get in that night, I want to get it in the next morning. But I was meditating upon the word that we had got Saturday night and Sunday night. And the Lord was showing me. He was like the temple. We are the temple of God. And he was showing me in the book of Revelation how that it says that the temple of God, it said, I looked into heaven. John said, I looked into heaven. And the temple was there. And the temple was open. And when the temple was open, there was the ark of the covenant of God. It was Jesus Christ that was seen. I tell you, Sister Joanne, when he showed me that, that light was so bright and so glorious, Sister Becky. It is a bright light and it will shine throughout a lost and dying generation. They have got hope, but the church has got some straightening up to do. The church is going to have to get back in place. Like the word says, we're going to have to get back to the altars and we're going to have to repent. Because he has given everybody every chance in the world, and he is still giving them chances, Sister Becky. He's calling on them and he's telling them to return and repent of your wicked ways, and you will be my people and I will be your God. I want to be his people. I plan on being his bride. I am bound and determined to stay a part of that bride. You know, I loved it when he showed me how that ark was and how bright and glorious it was. Sister Becky, I tell you what, I felt it all week long. I have felt that presence of the Lord that is being sealed up in the ark. The message that Brother Roger has been bringing forth is getting sealed in the ark. I think the time is drawing very nigh. I believe it's real close up on us. And he was just showing me just a little bit farther that we better be getting sealed. There's no think what's about it. You better know that you're sealed in Jesus. You better know that there's nothing else that can move you. We're getting ready to come up on times that without the Spirit of God leading and directing us, this old flesh will never say no. There's some things coming up on us that this old flesh can't say no to. We better be walking and sealed in that Spirit. I want it to be all him. You know, I praise him tonight, but he was showing me how important that it was that we are sealed in that ark, that we are sealed in his Sister Dolly. You know, the way he started showing me, I was starting thinking about Noah and how he was building the ark and how he told the people for 120 years he as he was building that ark, was telling that word. But the people didn't take no heed. They would not come and they would not repent until the door was shut up on the ark and they couldn't get in. They was left out, Brother Mark. They was left out, but Noah and his sons and his wife and their wives, 8 souls were saved, it said, because they were sealed in Jesus. That's exactly what it is, Sisterella, is being sealed in Jesus. He was taking me to Job and how that the hedge was let down and Satan tempted old Job. Oh, Job thought for surely that he was going to die, but he still wouldn't turn on the Lord. He still hung to his God, for he knew what a God that he had. He was unchangeable and unmovable. Are you unchangeable and unmovable tonight? We better be unchangeable and unmovable. We can't move off the foundation of God. We're going to have to stand on that foundation and be assured. I am fully persuaded that Jesus is going to take me through. But he was letting me know how that back in the olden times with the old prophets, how that they went into the ark. They went in, Moses, and when he was leading the children of Israel and Egypt there, and the plague come upon them for the firstborn son to die. They had to put the blood over the doorpost and over the head of the door, and they had to go in. But Jesus took me a little bit farther when he showed me that ark. He said in that day they went into the ark, but now this day the ark is in you. We're going to have to let the ark be shining out. I'm so glad that it's such a closer walk than the ark being us, and then us just having to run in it, because he's a leading and a guiding us till we can't make no mistakes as long as we let him do it. You know, I praise him tonight that he is a God that loves us so much that he came and he died on that cross so that he could come back again and take up a bone in our lives, that he may lead and guide us, and that we could not stray off, because he would always keep us. He said, what the Father has put in my hands, no man can pluck out. It's a good thing to be in his hands. It's a good thing to know that you can rest assured in Jesus. He is my rest, and I praise him for it. Brother Mark, he is just letting us know so much in this day, in this hour, because we don't have much time. I praise him tonight that he is doing that. I praise him that he's always leading and guiding us. You know, and I praise him that he has let me know that if you have been born again, that ark is in there. And you are in safety. You are in that ark and it is in you. You are in a safe place. But you got to get born again and you got to press on to know him for who he is. Because when this world is on fire and everything else is gone, the word of God is still going to be there. That word of God is that ark. His name is Jesus. We got to be in him. I praise him that he's letting us know that. I praise him that he went far enough to let us know that when the Holy Ghost comes, you have been born again. The Holy Ghost has come unto you. Then he will only testify of Jesus. There's no way you can be misled, because if it's testifying of anything else, then it ain't the Holy Ghost. It's got no Holy Ghost, because he said he would only testify of him. His name was Jesus. But I praise him tonight. You know, I've been excited. I've been excited all week long. I love the Word of God, and I love gathering at his feet. To me, that's getting with the family that is means more to me than anything is that family that is called by the name of Jesus and gathering at the Word's feet. I want to be there as often as I can. I want to stay at his feet, what I want to do. And I just don't want to get up and leave. I just want to stay right there, Brother Mark. But he has a work for us to do. But we got some learning to do. We got some repenting and straightening up to do. We got some getting that Word rooted and grounded in. You know, a garden wouldn't grow if the ground ain't plowed. You got to plow